my mom finally had to kill the whole deal and say, hey, you need to not come here anymore. She wanted to rent my parents an extra home. Not a little joke about. Like, she still reaches out to my mom. She sent me a 12-page letter.
Oh my God.
About how much she loved me.
Wow.
Joking about this shit. I mean, that's kind of my, it's like the worst that I've had much more weird shit like that.
What can you do? Give me something.
I have none of that one.
Have you ever been to a place like, you know, you're staying in a hotel or traveling with The Bachelor and somebody recognizes you or anything like that that like really went crazy?
There's been a lot of crazy times. There was one recently, maybe like 2 weeks ago. I was at Atlanta, one of the malls over there in Atlanta, and I had valeted, so I got in and I heard somebody screaming for a while. And I just went in and I was like, I gotta go real quick. And I love meeting everybody all the time, but I was in a rush. So I started taking off from the valet, and she jumped on the hood of my car screaming at me. And I had to stop, and I had to roll down my window, and I took a picture with her. And yeah, that's one.
That's what we call a free car wash.
Oh my God.
She was really nice, though. I appreciate it.
What do you got? You gotta give me something. There's something there.
So I moved in with Chase recently, in Denver. We moved with Chase. He was on hometown, so we had this really sweet girl that lived in the neighborhood. She brought her 4 best friends over, and one of them had cancer. They're all like 15. She was bald, she had one arm, super sweet girl. And her best friend who lived on the street actually reached out and said, you know, she's not doing well. Can you write her a letter and send her to the hospital? That would be great. Chase and I both did it, but as like without being conceited, your DMs kind of get clouded. Like, it's hard to keep up with everything that comes in. So we see it like a week and a half later, we both write letters, and it takes 3 days to get there. And unfortunately, she passed away before the letters got there. So it was super sad, but her mom took it upon herself to write a letter back to us, saying how much they appreciated the letters that we wrote. So that was one of the best experiences for my fan that I have done that.
Wow. Let me ask you one more question, because I know I'm keeping you guys here all night, but I want to ask you, what is the number one thing that you look for in a woman? What's the closing thing that a woman, when you see that moment, that you know?
Confidence.
Really? Confidence, how about you?
I want someone who's family oriented, wants kids, wants a family. That's it.
Chris?
All those things, in a sense of humor.
What he said.
It's tough to like just describe it in one word.
All right, I'm gonna come back though. And Alex, what's it for you?
Yeah, like, piggyback off of you said, I would say like loyalty. I feel confident someone's loyalty to you.
So as we take it back there, coming off this, what's the one thing that a woman can say to you that maybe that happened during a show that all of a sudden your head said, "Wow, this is a deal breaker. We're done." Of course, you guys need to smile through it and finish the show. Do you believe in aliens?
Don't really.
Game
Do you believe in aliens?
No, I really don't. Or are we in, what did she call it? The Mesa Verde. We're in Mesa Verde. It's the game changer.
Game changer, yep, we're done.
Peeling back the layers.
On the show, somebody said something, and when they said it, it was like a breaking point where you said, whoa, do you remember that moment?
Yeah, I think that for me and Robbie, where you go on and you put your whole entire life on hold, you're all in. Even though Robbie and I, during our experience, we were very close, we also had a very clear understanding of expectations, like how things were going to play out. And I don't know, I think that when it comes down to it, I think that you can go through a lot of things on the show. When it comes down to it, people are going to say a lot of things that, like, a lot of people will respond differently to. You and I think we got to as far on the show as we did because we were able to compartmentalize a lot of things happening throughout the show. When it comes down to someone who we all believe shouldn't be around because it just sounds like a joke or whatever it is, don't need to name names. When those things happen, you sit there and you say, all right, like, how is this even, how are men like us even still in the same competition as men like that? And when majority rules and that kind of conversation, that's when you start wondering, like, what the fuck are you doing right now? Like, why are we even here? So,
Chad, how about you? Somebody say something on the show, like a woman. And all, well, we went there. That was when have you been on this planet? Let's go. Send the mic down. How about to you? Was there a moment where somebody said something, and all of a sudden you said, "That's a deal breaker. It's not going to happen." But you kept going. You were polite. But it was a moment during the show when you were talking with a woman. You know.
I don't know. I don't think anything was a deal breaker because I got engaged both times.
Well, but leading up on that, you had to go on a few
dates. No, I'm just saying. There probably should have been stuff that, in retrospect, right, if I go back and I think about it and I look into it and I dig deeper, that there's things that would have been a deal breaker, but they weren't for me. I probably should have asked more questions to figure out those answers that would have been a deal breaker, yeah? And I didn't. But the thing is, you really don't get to know somebody in their true self, that I found out, until after the show when no cameras are on. And when you live with somebody, when you get to figure out their day-to-day lives, when you just know them, that's when everything changes. So the big thing is, you've got to be yourself while you're on the show and not portray somebody just for the camera so people can be excited about you. Be yourself all the time, because if you're not, then the relationship's not going to work out afterwards because you're being fake.
Awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, here they are, man. Give them a big round of applause. Everybody gets a rose tonight. If you do not get one, please help yourself. Thanks to these folks who brought all these great roses. And thanks to the bouncers and cast.
Hey, thank you everybody for coming out, seriously.
The fans, big round of applause for you guys. Thank you so much. Passion roses.